This is James Held of Firefall TV in association with Matt Clinch, Jim Marbauer. With me, I've got Tom Stalker. We're at the press conference today for Liam Smith defending his WBO world title against Predrag Radosovic. Also on the card, challenging for the WBO European title, Mr. Tom Stalker. How are you, sir?
Hello, son.
How are you? It's been a little while, mate.
It's been a while. I haven't boxed this year. I've had, it's been one of them, boxed November or, yeah, boxed November
that
or December.
Don't seem that long ago, does it?
And then I was supposed to fight on the first Flanagan build. He got injured. Because I've been in the gym back in the last year, yeah, I was fighting constantly. And my manager said to me, he said, I want you to have a break. He said, I've a couple of weeks off with the family because my baby just had a new baby.
Congratulations, Tom.
Yeah, yep, well, she's like 4 or 6 months now, but yep. I have a couple of months with the baby, just a bit of normality. And I've been in the gym now for this camp, for this fight, I've done like the 13 weeks. Just done everything, my food's being right, done everything right. So me and I'm excited to fight because I know I've done everything right for the fight. And you put me in with anyone on Saturday, the way I feel like I'll beat anyone. So, you know, I'm looking forward to getting in there and finally winning this belt.
You say finally, mate, you've had some good cracks at it. You've been in some wars for this belt so far. Third time of asking, how confident are you? You'll finally get your hands on this WBO title.
I'm very, very, very confident. Just on like what I've done in the gym and, you know, being with that my trainer Danny Bourne now just over a year, we're clicking in the gym, everything's going well in the gym, and that's very important, you know what I mean? I struggled to adapt, but I'm adapting now, and he's broke me down and rebuilt me, and I'm slowly getting there, being doing a lot of strength with Stephen out of MGM. He's been doing all my strength with me 3 times a week, like old school sort of strength where you just like pull-ups, dips, all that hard stuff. It's been good. I've enjoyed the camp. I left Spain Tuesday. I was a pound over my weight, and that's lightweight, and that's brilliant for me. So I haven't really done much this week, and I'll just be investing in that. And so a little skip later on, take a couple of pounds off, ready to weigh in tomorrow, and then ready to fight Saturday.
Now, I know you stayed at the Marriott last night. I want to cast your mind back to 10 to 12 years ago. A young Tom Stalker, your first ever job with Mr. Thorpe washing dishes. And you were reunited with him today.
It
must show your progress, how far you've came as a person since then.
Yeah.
Since being a young sort of young worker to where you are now, Tom.
Do you know what it was? I always stay in Hilton. I thought, I'll be with the Marriott because I haven't been back since I was a kitchen porter. And remember it like it was yesterday. I was My girlfriend was pregnant. I think she just had Ellie's nearly 13, not in September. So she's like, I'm gonna have to get a job. It's like, oh. So before that, I was out freaking petty crime, bobbing cars and all that bollocks. And so I rang my cousin. I was like, any jobs going? Because I knew he was working in the Marriott. He was a night porter. She went, there's a job here washing dishes. So I was like, says to me, babe, what do you think? She went, yeah, go for it. So I was like, how much a week? Under £60 a week I was on, Jay, right? So I went, and you know what, mate, I was there for 2 years, washing dishes. But this is just as a first start of boxing, so I'd work 6 a.m. till 2 p.m, go home, have 2 hours sleep, then I'd be back in the gym then, in the night, and I'd do that. And babe was like, you know, let's just pack this box in the face, because I was working all day, no quality time. So when I go back to today, first time in 13 years going in there today, in the kitchen, I was like, nothing's changed. And the chef who used to work with, and it was very touching to think, all the time I was there, and I've come a long way going back there. I remember going in, and Jamie McKeever was fighting for the British title, and he come in and give me 3 tickets. So I went in today and gave Tommy Cork some 3 tickets for looking after me.
That's blinding. You mentioned some interesting things in the press conference today. You said anyone else with the sort of the results you had last season would be fearing for their contract. And you said it in a light-hearted way, but I sort of felt for you a little bit then by them comments. Could you elaborate on that?
No, it's the truth of, like, look, first and foremost, I've got Daniel, MJ and Marvey behind me, the strongest people to have behind you for any promotional outfit, if you're with Eddie Hearn or you're with Frank Warren, because they're just straight. Now, With Daniel and MGM, it's like, you know, I'll have done a lot of favours for Frank, for Eddie Hearn, and he's a good guy. MGM's a good, strong stable. So last year I drew 3 fights. Should I still be on the same money I'm getting for having 3 draws? No, my money should get dropped because of Daniel and MGM and the setup. I've kept the same money. I'm still getting, and the most important thing, I'm getting the opportunities to fight again for this WBO European title. I win on Saturday, I get a top 15 world ranking. Now, you know, anything can happen. I'm not saying, like, Terry Flanagan has a lot of enemies, defended his belt a lot of times, but if he wanted an easy defence, you know, we're both with Frank Warren, with the powers, it could get made. That's like look at Liam Smith's opponent today. He's WBO European champion. That's why he's got the fight with Liam Smith. So, you know, it's about having a good, strong team behind me. And what it is as well, Jay, they've done everything for me over there in MGM, and it's about time I won this belt and brought it back and said thank you for everything what they've done for me.
I was going to say that. Do you feel you need to start delivering and maybe sort of putting in that extra 10% because of the way you've been sort of treated when you weren't on the up, when things were going against you, when you weren't getting the rub of the green, so to speak?
Exactly. Well, you find out who's there for you when things aren't going well. I got beat against Cattle. Daniel's first person was our man when he went, don't worry, we're just till the end. And he's done that and more for me. He's been with me, like, done everything for me. And it'd be nice to win the belt and for him and the whole of MGM. There's not just Daniel, there's Anto, there's the team, just like in the gym. We're just all like a big family, and it's nice that to have something like that. I left the GB team good to thinking, would I ever find anything that I had on the GB team? And that's what I've got over in Spain. So I think winning Saturday, winning this belt, will be a big thing for me. And, you know, I've got my daughter, she's nearly 13. She wants me to win this belt more than anyone, as well as my girlfriend. So there's a lot on the line for me. I've got to win this belt because I don't want to go back to Spain and facing my daughter and that without the belt. That's why I know I'm going to win Saturday.
Listen, well done for not listening to the missus 12 years ago, packing it up and becoming head chef at the Marriott, mate. You know, you've done well.
Just so you know, she'll be going, I didn't say that, because my bird stands by me 110%. She's a good girl, been with her 15 years. So yeah, just she's like, why did you say that? Like, I don't stand by her, but she stands by me. She's a good girl, so thank you.
On that note, thank you very much, Tom.
Thanks,
I'll catch you again at the Wayne. Thank you, sir.
Go on, bye now.